لا لايف ديالي. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين وهو خير معين. Respected viewers, respected brothers and sisters in Iman, tonight we are here at Al Mahdi Center, Brooklyn, New York, having a small workshop regarding Eid-e-Zahra alayhi salam. Ninth Rabi'ul Awwal is the day of Eidul Zahra. In Arabic, we say Haflatul Zahra. In Urdu, we say Eid-e Zahra. What basically Eid-e Zahra is? The day when head of Umar ibn Saad was presented to our fourth Imam after revenge of Karbala, Amir Mukhtar alayhi rahmah sent few heads, cut heads of killers, remaining killers of martyrs of Karbala. And 9th Rabiul Awal was the day when these remaining heads were presented to our fourth Imam. Don't jump like that. Don't jump like that. Imam alayhi salam smiled first time. That was the day, that was the only day when fourth Imam smiled. And we presume that day as Eid. As Eid. Eid-ul-Zahra, why it is not Eid of Zainul Abidin? Why it is Eid-ul-Zahra? Because here of Imam Hussain and his family is basically Sayyida Fatimatul-Zahra. She is going to complain on the day of judgment against the killing of her son and family members and other martyrs of Karbala, because she is warith of Qaza. And we know from our childhood, wherever Majlis-e-Hussain is there, our holiest lady is there. So because she is warith of Qaza, that is why we say it is Eid of Zahra, who is waris of Aza. Her entire family celebrated Eid on this particular day of 9th. Eid-e-Zahra has basically six names. Let me tell you all of these names. First is Eid-e-Zahra. Second is Haflatul-Zahra. Hafla from Mahfil. Hafla. Mahafil, Mahfil. Haflatul-Zahra. Third name is Eid-e-Nohum. Eid-e-Nohum. It is famous in our culture. Eid-e-Nohum. Ninth day of Rabiul Awwal. Eid of ninth day of Rabiul Awwal. Nohum means ninth. Fourth name is Eid-e-Shaja', Eid-e-Shaja' or Shuja'. Shuja' or Shaja' both have been used as brave, because Mukhtar was bravest person of the nation of Muhammad of that time. This is the Eid of Mukhtar, titled as Eid-e-Shuja'. Shuja means Mukhtar. Mukhtar is Shuja, brave. And we are supposed to learn bravery from Mukhtar. How he took the revenge of Karbala and then got killed by zulm and oppression. But he never cared. This is our identity, that we do not care even if we are going to be killed for Ahlul Bayt. Right now, you are witness. Our community is being killed in Syria, in Bahrain, in Saudi Arabia, in Afghanistan, in Pakistan, and global wise. But Alhamdulillah, Iraq. Daily they kill us, our community. But Alhamdulillah, we are loyal to Ahlul Bayt. We don't care. Out of us was Mukhtar. Mukhtar was born by the supplication of Imam Hussein. When Imam Hussein was a child, his mom came to Bibi Fatima and asked her, "I do not conceive. Is there any particular way that I can get child?" Holiest Lady Fatima said, "Go and ask my youngest son to pray for you." Imam Hussein prayed for her and she got Mukhtar. Mukhtar was born due to dua of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So third, fourth name is Eid-e-Shaja. Fifth name of this Eid is Jashn-e-Amir-e-Mukhtar alayhi rahma. Because Amir means governor. Mukhtar was governor. Amir means governor. Amir Mukhtar, governor of Kufa, who took rule just for the sake of revenge. He did not have any selfish motive, and he has been buried after being killed and martyred in Kufa, in Masjid-e-Kufa. Right across the tomb of Ambassador of Hussein, Muslim bin Aqil, alayhi salam, there are two companions of Imam buried there. One is Hani bin Urwa, who was killed by lashes of Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad's army. They hit him until he was martyred. He was killed. But up to the last moment of his life, he showed loyalty to the family of Prophet. The second is Mukhtar, who got revenge of Karbala. And on the 9th of Rabiul Awal, we celebrate Jashn Amir Mukhtar, because Amir Mukhtar celebrated Jashn, particularly this day, because this was the day when last revenge of Karbala was completed by killing of Umar ibn Saad ibn Abi Waqas. Umar Saad was general of army of Yazid. And due to the greed of government of Tehran, which is titled as Rey, he killed Imam Hussein. And Umar ibn Saad was that bad person that Bibi Zainab alayhi salam, when Imam Hussein was being killed, she said, أتنظره يا ابن سعد ويقتل أبو عبد الله shame on you O son of Sa'd you are watching and my brother is being killed so this was worst enemy of Ahlul Bayt he was brother-in-law of Mukhtar Mukhtar's sister was his wife and see the loyalty of Mukhtar he killed husband of his sister and he never cared so, alhamdulillah this is basically theology which we are preserving we are happy today because we are celebrating Eid al-Zahra Haflat al-Zahra Eid Shaja Jashn Amir Mukhtar Eid al-Nohm and the last name of sixth name of this Eid is Jashn Taj Poshi of Imam Zaman alayhi salam Ninth Rabiul Awal was the first day when Imam Zaman alayhi salam became practicing leader of the community Imam of the time after the martyrdom of his father Imam Hassan Askari alayhi salam who was martyred on 8th of Rabiul Awal 9th of Rabiul Awal is Eid when Ahlul Bayt even after few years cooked food first time in their houses otherwise nobody smelled smoke felt smoke from the houses of Bani Hashim almost 5 years nobody saw smoke from the houses of Ahlul Bayt that said they were this was the only day when Ahlul Bayt were happy they celebrated this day as a Eid and we the Shias of Ahlul Bayt follow the saying of our first Imam as he said Shiatuna khuliqu min fazil tinatina yafrahuna li farahina wa yahzununa li huznina we Shias our Shias are made by the leftover material of us Ahlul Bayt that is why they are happy when we are happy they are sad when we are sad that is why we are celebrating this Eid today if you have any question regarding this significant date of Islam you are more than welcome to ask any question leader of the army you can say general basically he was general and he was suspended later on the power was given to Shimr more than him but he was kind of you can say kind of general few generals were there basically each leader of the army had group of 1000 people Umar Saad came with 1000 Hur came with 1000 people Shimr came with 1000 Haseen bin Nawir came with 1000 you may say general you may say leader yes he was and then they made some change they took some power from him and they gave more power to Shimr
Shimr was also getting order from
yes yes that's correct yes Shimr was getting order from Umar Saad. Shimr was killing Imam Hussain and Umar Saad was telling him how to kill. Yes. Yeah, go ahead. Alaykum As-salam.
Was Shimr denied this could be your prayer or as soon as he got in there, he was snapped away from
him? No. They never denied. No. They never got it. Imam Hussain said, you will never achieve and obtain that government even you will not even receive a single grain of that land. So this was kind of baddua of Imam against the Shimr and Umar Saad. Some of our simple people, they assume Imam doesn't do baddua. Who said? Imam had done a lot of baddua. Qatala Allahu man qatala waladi. Qatala Allahu nasla man qatala nasli. Qatala nasli. A lot. Bibi Zainab alayhi salam had done a lot of baddua. Yes, baddua is from Quran. The Prophet used to do baddua for the oppressors. You cannot do dua for oppressors. This is misconception about our Imams. Yes, Mustafa. Bibi Fatima was martyred before that. Bibi Zainab was arrested. Umm Kulsoom, Bibi Ruqayya, Fatima Kubra, Bibi Sakina, Lababa, Fizza, Layla, Rabab, and other ladies. The wives of brothers of Imam Hussain. Imam Hussain's 9 brothers were killed in Karbala. 10th was Imam Hussain. 10 sons of Imam Ali were martyred in Karbala. Out of 18, total 18, out of 18, 10 were martyred in Karbala. Few years. Yes. Basically, Ali Zubair and Umayyads were same in the beginning. Then there were some controversies and fights among them. And then they were kicked out. Umayyads, they thought Ali Zubair are not fulfilling their promise. Due to that, they kicked them out. And later on, Umayyads were kicked out by Abbasis, who also deceived and cheated. They came by the name of revenge of Imam Hussain, and they killed the sons of Imam Hussain. Even they were burying the children of Sadat alive in Baghdad. Yes. They used to bury them alive in the walls of Baghdad. None of them were good. Neither Umayya nor Bani Abbas. Yes. Dr. Liaquat, Bismillah. Yeah, go ahead.
2 days ago in the khutbah of Jumah, Maulana Raiz Afghani said that if anybody who visits the shrine of Imam Hussain, he gets the benefit of 90,000 umrahs.
Okay. Yeah, very nice. Thank you, Dr. Liaquat. May Allah give you good health. Nice to see you after a while. Yeah, mashallah, our Dr. Liaquat Hayat is one of our brothers who got Basharat by Imam Ali alayhi salam. He saw Imam Ali, and Imam Ali directed him to come to Al-Mahdi Center. Alhamdulillah, he came and he got his problem solved by the Basharat of Imam Ali alayhi salam. So he is very learned man. MashaAllah, PhD, Doctor of Philosophy. And his question is very nice. Let me tell you, first question. Visiting the shrine of Imam Hussain, we have a lot of ahadith. I have collected 500 hadith regarding the reward of visiting of shrine of Imam Hussain. Out of those 500, I got even more than that which Maulana Zafar Ali said. I got one hadith of Prophet. If someone visits shrine of my son in Karbala on Arbaeen, will have reward of 300,000 Hajj and Umrah. Alhamdulillah. So all these hadiths are correct because the investment which Imam Hussain done and invested for God was more than each and every prophet and imam. But it does not mean that if you get sawab of Umrah and Hajj, the Umrah and Hajj is going to be exempt. No. That is still due. You have to do that. Reward is, that is correct. There is no doubt in this kind of a hadith. Let me share with you. Once Bibi Aisha asked Prophet, when he was kissing Imam Hussain, Prophet did not love anyone in his life more than Hussain. When he was kissing Imam Hussain, Bibi Aisha asked Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, atuhibbuhu? You love him? Kala na'am. How much? How much you love him? Then Prophet said, if someone will visit my son Hussein's shrine, Allah will give him a reward of one Hajj and one Umrah. Maqbula. She said, Ya Rasulallah, that much? The visiting of shrine of Hussein will be equal to one Hajj? Prophet said, no, 10 Hajj. She said, 10 Hajj? Prophet said, 20. She said, 20? Prophet said, 30. She said, 30? Prophet said, 40. Prophet acceded to 90, and then she kept quiet. Prophet asked her, Aisha, limaza ma tas'alini? Why you are not asking more? Fawallazi nafsu Muhammadin bayadi. لَوْ تَسْأَلِينِ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ لَزَادَ اللَّهُ السَّوَابَ زِيَارَةِ الْحُسَيْنِ. If you were asking until the day of judgment, Allah was increasing the reward of visiting of shrine of Hussain. So this is the answer of Dr. Liaquat. Reason I told, investment. Imam Hussain's investment is more than each and every person. He is the savior of system of Allah. He is not only pioneer, he is the savior of system of Tawheed, system of prophecy, system of justice, peace, system of Quranic education, system of Wahi. So, the Alhamdulillah, you have any question? So, you can do Hajj that much you want. There is no restriction. You can go Hajj for 100 times. Umrah for 100 times. You can go Ziyarat for 100 times. May Allah give you long life. One Hajj is mandatory. Beside that Hajj, all will become recommended. But this is my humble request. Go to Imam Hussain. Visit the shrine of Imam Hussain and follow the lifestyle of Imam Hussain. There should be smell of Hussain from our character. Hussain ibn Ali was that punctual of prayer that he offered his last prayer on time and congregational prayer. If we avoid from congregational prayer, we avoid from praying on time, exact time, it means we are just having slogans. There is no practice. It's my humble request from all of you that please follow the lifestyle of Imam Hussain. That is why we are here. Today we are gathered to celebrate Jashn of Eid al-Zahra, to make sure that we follow the footsteps of Zahra. Our sisters, I will urge them, when you finish your jashan, your majalis, at the time of prayer, don't run away from the masjid. Offer the prayer and then go away. Or when you want to start majlis or jashan, ladies or gents, please do not start on the time of prayer. First offer the prayer, And then you go ahead and start. Imam Hussain stopped his jihad due to prayer. So please pay some importance to the lifestyle of Imam Hussain.
I have one question.
Go ahead.
Many Muslims claim that Musa,
Samad is asking a question that some of the people, they claim that they saw Prophet in dream. Answer is, some of them are 100% right and some of them are 100% wrong. Because you may see Prophet and you may not. Maybe some of people, they are lying. But you can see Prophet. It's experienced if you follow the lifestyle of Prophet. Why not? You can see Prophet in the dream. But that should be certain that you saw Prophet, because Shaitan or Jinn cannot come in the shape of infallible. So if you believe that was Prophet, inshallah that is Prophet. But don't tell people. Don't tell people. Otherwise you will lose that opportunity. Some of the people, they see one time and they tell 1,000 times. It's not good. This is riya, show off. And some people even, I know, they speak false. This is not good. Do not say. If you did not see, do not say. Yeah. And if you saw Prophet one day, it doesn't mean that up to the day of judgment you are now Bilal or Salman. No. Maybe you are bad tomorrow. Visiting of Prophet will not be cause that you are now permanent Raziallahu ta'ala anhu or Rahmatullah alayh. Keep struggling. Yes. Islam is not a degree or certificate. Islam is the name of continuous struggle and practice. Last question, and then we'll start, inshallah, darshan in Urdu. Yeah, go ahead. Alaykum salam, Kareem.
One other question. When Jubair bin Abu Ansari, radiallahu anhu, came on the 40th day to Karbala, did he ever get to go after that and speak to Yazid?
No. Jabir ibn Abdullah Ansari, companion of Prophet Raziallahu ta'ala anhu, who has quoted Hadith se Kisa, basically. He was loyal companion of Prophet. And he was even friend of Imam Hussain. They were almost in same age group. A little older than Imam Hussain, few years. Like Habib, also Habib ibn Mazahir. He came 40th day next year, not the first year. First year, nobody came to Karbala. Beside some people of Bani Asad. Because they did not even know to celebrate, to commemorate the 40th day. They did not know. There was no trend. Only 40th day was commemorated for Hussein, not even for Prophet, not for Imam Ali, not for Bibi Fatima. So you don't celebrate, don't commemorate 40th day of Imam Ali. Only Soim, third day, and 40th day is for Imam Hussein. So first year nobody came. Second year, when 40th day came, 20th Safar, first visitor, pilgrim, whoever came to Karbala was Jabir, and second was his slave. Atiyah is a lady's name, but it was for a man. Atiyah, like Talha. We assume that it is a female. Atiyah was slave of Jabir and Jabir, these two people. And after these both, Imam Zain al-Abideen, along with 17 more people, 12 ladies, 5 children, including Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salam, and one leader of caravan, 18 people total, 18 and 220. So 20th day, Imam Hussain got 20 zair. That's 20th day of Safar. 20th day of Safar, 40th day of Shahadat, Imam Hussain got 20. Pilgrims. Is that satisfactory for you? Haji Karim? Okay. Anything? Ali? Ali Rizvi? Nothing? MashaAllah, inshallah, we'll continue this from 2nd February. You have vacation until February 2nd. Inshallah, we're going to open the school and we'll have majlis also for Chatta family, Marhumin of Chatta family. And inshallah, our Sunday school, our Quranic class will get start, Dars-e Quran, from February the 2nd. Until that, you are off. Now I will request Brother Javed Hussain to please start the Jashan in Urdu. No question left. Everybody knows what is Eid-e Zahra. You know what is Jashan-e Amir-e Mukhtar. You know what is Eid-e Shuja. You know what is Tajposhi of Imam-e Zaman. Is that correct? You know what is Haflatul Zahra. And who celebrated first? Imam Zain al-Abidin along with the ladies. And why it is Eid-e Zahra? Because Zahra is happy at this particular day. Inshallah, next Sunday you will have Jashan of Sadiqain. So inshallah, you will have more information about Prophet and Imam Sadiq. Salamullahi alayhima. Salawat.